Photogrammetry is a great way to take 2D images and create highly detailed 3D meshes from 2D photographs. Here I have an apple that I used photogrammetry to create a 3D mesh with. It even has the texture maps already on it. The problem with photogrammetry is that it doesn't have any scale information in the format, so it just creates a 3D mesh. I don't know if this apple is 20 feet tall or just a couple millimeters. A way to help your photogrammetry meshes fit in real-world units is to lay down some scale devices. Here I have two tape measures simply crossed at two angles. It's important to use more than one measurement device so you can check how accurate your scale is. Before doing any scale operations with photogrammetry meshes, make sure everything is aligned correctly. Look at the cardinal directions such as Y, X, and Z. It looks pretty flat. But if I click on Z, looking straight down, I need to rotate it. In Blender, I'll press R, Z, and rotate it in the Z axis. Now I have the rulers much more aligned with the way they're supposed to be. Next, press Shift A, create a cube. Press N to see the item properties. We're interested in the dimensions. First, I'm going to press G, Shift Z to move this cube. Then I'm going to look at this ruler at the top. This ruler has some mess up over here. If I look from 2 to 18, that seems pretty reasonable and legible. I want to use the biggest dimension possible for the most accuracy. So 18 minus 2 is 16. I'm going to select all the dimensions, type 16 space IN for inches. And now this cube is exactly 16 inches. I've never seen a 16-inch apple, so definitely I need to fix my scale. With the cube selected, press Tab. Select this top corner, then press Shift S, cursor to select it. Now the 3D cursor is right on the corner. Tab out of edit mode. In object mode, select the photogrammetry scan. Press G, Shift Z, then move it close so the 2-inch mark is on the 3D cursor. Always make sure that you are looking straight down. You may not realize that you're tilted, so always click Z and look straight down. Hold Shift and middle mouse button to pan, then press G, Shift Z, and move that into position. There's a limit to how close you can get, but if you look here, I'm splitting that line with the corner. By default, Blender moves everything around the median point, but at the top, you can select 3D cursor. That means scale and rotation operations will now happen around this 3D cursor. That's great because now I don't have to worry about moving the mesh when I scale it. With the photogrammetry mesh selected, press S to scale and scale it down or up depending on what you need. Just get it close on this first one. Then zoom in. Remember, this is 16 inches long, our cube. And then I can press S and move that 18 in right to where it needs to go. And you can see that I need to rotate a little bit, but luckily, since our 3D cursor is right on the corner of the box, I can just press R, Z and rotate it. And I think that's pretty dead on. It's right about in the middle of the 18. So now I'll zoom out, and this should be approximately the right size. And if you think about an apple, yeah, apples are 2 to 3 inches. On this cube, I'm gonna rename it 16 inches. Then press Shift D, duplicate it, and move it to the side. Hide the original cube. Looking at the other ruler that we're going to use for calibration of our scale, I can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And even this one's a little messy, so probably 11 inches is the max. So with this second cube selected, select all the dimensions and type 11 space IN. Now this is an 11-inch cube. Notice that it's down below. That's fine. Yours may be up above. Press G, Z to move it in the Z direction. And I like using cubes that are the same dimension in all directions because it makes it easier with 3D objects to see the ruler. Remember, these are just for guides. Look straight down. Since we've already scaled our photogrammetry mesh, we don't want to move it. So select the cube, G, Shift Z, and move it into position. I'm going to zoom in to make sure it's right on the ruler mark, then G, Shift Z, and right about there, I think is pretty good. Now let's see if it's really 11 inches. As I come down here, I notice that I'm off by a 16th of an inch. So that's pretty small and pretty accurate. Perhaps the rulers were at an angle or aren't perfectly calibrated to each other, which is often the case in the real world. But you definitely want to have two measurements. Depending on what you're doing with your model, this may be accurate enough. If I look here, you can see that these two rulers kind of curve a little bit in the photogrammetry, so perhaps they aren't perfectly represented. Make sure that you add more rulers in more places that you can calibrate your measurements with when you're trying to scale a photogrammetry mesh. Hopefully this helps you get your photogrammetry mesh into real-world units and scale, and then use it in all your 3D modeling projects. Happy 3D modeling!